here's an update on my mid-70s Sony TC-580 reel-to-reel tape recorder. After a month of being fixed and repaired, it finally runs. I cleaned the heads with some contact on there. I mean, if you have recognized that, if you saw my last video back about a month ago on my demonstration of my Sony TC-580 reel-to-reel tape recorder, I'm just going to show you. It's been a month now because after my uncle, since I got that from my uncle, the one my uncle gave that to me back in April, after I did some of my repairs, I fixed it. It was working fine, but especially with the left channel was dead. So after a fix, after some repairs and stuff like that, after cleaning all the heads and things like that, it finally kicks butt once again. And as you see here, the right arrow and the left arrow is now running. Look at that. It's nice. Yeah, it is working. So this is very interesting. Thanks to my my Sears Silvertone tape recorder maintenance kit, which I had, the one my uncle gave that to me back in April. It's like a new old stock brand made by Sears. I refilled it with this one because it's using a vintage tape recorder head cleaner. You see right here, I refilled a little bit of it. So I have to get more of these from Radio Shack soon to get more refills. I don't know if some online store sells these or whatever it is. Along with the recording lubricant is on there because I just try to give it a little try here. And after so many head cleaning and stuff, it works. And the left channel is fixed once again. So now I'm going to give you, for a demonstration, here it is. This is a more updated version. I'm going to redo this, and this is, I actually use a microphone. I just try to test it out and see what it is. After about a month of repairing, here it is once again with my demonstration. Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. I am recording with my Sony TC-580 reel-to-reel tape recorder, the one that my uncle gave me. I got this from probably back in April. I just give a little bit of update here. After a month of fixing the unit, I cleaned the heads, and of course, the light that indicates the right and the left arrows, it still works. Now working. When I originally had this back in April, it was, the capstan motor was frozen, was dead. So I decided to lubricate it, and of course, running the motor as well. And then after a couple of weeks, I decided to go back to Radio Shack when I got a head cleaning fluid, which is like an audio video cleaning fluid. I refilled it using an old Silvertone head cleaning fluid, which is kind of empty, so I had to refill that. After that, after a few of those major cleanings, using that with the Q-tip, I cleaned the heads, and it works. And of course, after all it's said and done, I'm recording it in very good quality. And you know what? It's a pretty good, interesting tape recorder. And as you probably see here, I'm recording at 7.5 inches per second. I'm using two microphones, which the one that my uncle gave me, which are two vintage microphones, which is kind of metal. And of course, CassetteMaster also has the same model, which is actually with the head cover is still intact. But the only problem is missing, which is the head cover and the pinch roller cover is missing. What a bummer, which I think, I don't know why, if it's very hard to find. And of course, it still works, but it's missing, except the piece missing is the left hub for the left reel, because I had to avoid it, so I have to tilt it a little bit further to make it more playback as well, to make it doesn't so it won't fall off, never let it go. So, for one thing, I'm just going to use it right, this two microphones right now. Oh, just one thing, I'm speaking directly with the left channel of my Sony TC-580, and I'm speaking close to the right channel of my Sony TC-580, and now both channels separately. I'm using both microphones, and to me, this is AC bias. Of course, this is an AC bias unit. It's very top-notch quality. I know some of the other YouTubers that have, especially CassetteMaster, as I said, has the exact same model that he had shown on YouTube, that he posted it back in 2007. That he said that he made a video on Sansui 660 Technics RS588US and HH Scott S10 speakers or so. These are excellent, excellent top-notch reel-to-reel tape decks, or as well as the Sansui stereo receiver, and of course, Technics 8-track recorder. I know, because very much like this. It's a pretty interesting unit. So I'll just give a little update here. So I'm recording at 7.5 inches per second, and now we're going to speed it down a bit. I'm speaking at 3.75 inches per second. Is actually, it's on the medium setting, which is a pretty interesting unit. But talking very clearly, and it's pretty interesting. It's running at the medium speed. It's 3.75 inch IPS. And now we're going to go down to the lower setting. I'm also be speaking at 1.78 IPS, and actually it's not very well. It's not that bad for its quality, because depending on the speeds, it's kind of like it's a slow speed at 1.78 inches per second. It's pretty decent quality, I think. It comes in very well with that. So I'm gonna give a shout out to other YouTubers out there. Vinyl Records Never Die, All American Five Radio, Spence Bear, and a bunch of a few others who loves reel-to-reel tape recorders, especially CassetteMaster, and of course the Real Master, and Urban Explorer 1996, and a few others. Not to say who, but we'll just have to say about it. So let's see how this thing sounds. And now, for some music here. For other YouTubers out there who posted a song called Macaron Checaroon by Il Tumbo. And hear how it sounds. Let's see how this thing goes.
Very nice, interesting reel-to-reel deck. As I said before, CassetteMaster, if you saw his video back in 2007, if you had to review it back, let's show this again, shall we? This is for you, CassetteMaster. If you haven't seen this back in 2007, here's a video that he did back in June. That was like probably about 4 years ago that he posted on YouTube.
And then hooked up also to the Sansui 6060. Sony TC-580 reel-to-reel deck. Although looking on the internet for the model, found out it's probably not one of the most reliable units for the auto reverse and stuff. But still, it is a nice deck. Got it from an estate sale, along with two pairs of Dynaco A25 speakers. That's four Dynaco A25 speakers and this deck, all for $30. Now, is that a deal or is that a deal? Anyway, you play it.
So I don't want to go into copyright issues here. Was this Carmen McRae's Rock Me, Baby? I'm not going to post that. I'm not going to try to avoid copyright issues here from YouTube, but...
Three motor servo control.
Oh.
Meters.
Yep.
Very nice. Auto.
Yep, the hub was still intact.
Sony, three motor servo control.
Yeah, it does have the head cover. It used to have a head cover, remember this? If you've seen here.
Very nice. Auto.
Yes, the tape hub was still good, especially my version, the same model I have, is missing the left hub of the reels. And the original head cover that says Sony 3 Motor Servo Retro, no, 3 Motor Servo Control, I meant, which is the one that usually had it, but now the brand name is gone. Yeah, but it's missing the original head cover. And sadly, that has the pinch roller cover is missing. But the only thing is, actually, the tape counter does not move. So...
Sony, three motors.
Yeah, as you see here, control. As I said, my same model has, except it's missing, yeah, and the other piece broke off when I got it. The power switch, it looks like it broke off when I got it. Yeah.
The original owners have a clean head. One of the record heads is worn and therefore records slightly weak on the left channel in the forward direction.
I know, I cleaned the heads very well.
Down the right channel.
Yeah, and it's kind of weak in the right channel, so I adjust the meter a bit.
You can see it there. Back on.
Yep, there, same heads. I'm not going to go into interfering copyright issues
this
here.
This song here was recorded with the TAC-850W. I recorded good on both channels.
Alright, yep, same controls. It looks almost like this, similar, but...
Real awesome here.
It has a fast-forward deck. Yeah, I had to replace... I had to put a new belt for the counter here.
I don't like that. Then I'm turning things. I turn fast. Looks like it's kind of just skipping by in a weird way.
Yeah, but you can see here...
But it's a nice deck.
But,
and therefore,
I don't know what the mob's here.
This song,
you see here that the left knob is actually still, it's different, but look at that, it's similar, same knobs, but you can see that it's similar, but very nice, interesting unit. For now, the recording I made from YouTube. Here it is. Here's a test for this song. Check it out. Listen to this.
Oh, yeah. Yo, macaron. Yeah, macaron. No. Chacaron. 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 Chacaron.
Wow, this is, I recorded this from YouTube. See that? The left channel is working, works perfectly, especially the right channel. I guess I adjust the auxiliary control on there, on the right channel. Yeah, to make it more sound much better. And you can see, the monitor switch source to tape is still good. It has a headphone, level 1, level 2, tape select, special. Take a look at this. Look at this. This is a VU meter. I guess Gilmore 509 on YouTube actually had a TAC with an auto reverse control. I don't know what the heck. And now, let's go down to this. Oh yeah, it slows down. Slows down like crazy. Listen to this. Slows down. Macaron chuckaron in slow motion. Sounds like a monster. Now let's slow us down to 178. Wow! Now let's get to this stuff right now. Pretty funny. It's pretty weird. Sounds like a monster, and you never heard of it before. It's macaron chuckaron like you never heard it before. Now let's go to the auto reverse. Yeah, it's blank. I just recorded blank, so I just had to give a little try here. Yeah, it has an auto reverse feature. But now let's get back to the music. Pretty much. I always love this. Gotta love this unit. And now for the rewind. Yep, spins way too. It has turbocharged rewind switch. And now, turbocharged fast forward. There you go. That's it. That's my update on my Sony TC-580 reel-to-reel tape recorder. Yeah, we should get credit to CassetteMaster for that video that he posted back in 2007. Way back in 2007, 4 years ago, he did it. But now, after like years of finding a reel-to-reel deck, I am so glad my uncle gave me this one when he brought it in when my uncle lives down in Florida. He gave me this one back in early April, gave me this two tape recorders, this one is here, along with a Akai 1721W reel-to-reel tape recorder, the one I had before when I showed you in my previous video. It's pretty much like this, anyways. I always enjoyed that very much. I know CassetteMaster hasn't seen, has yet, you've seen me posted the demonstration of a Akai reel-to-reel deck, which I have shown, because it doesn't record very well. I checked the microphone, it doesn't come out very well when it was recording. It doesn't come out well on playback, because it had a built-in speaker with it. So, I don't know how to figure this thing out, so I was trying to get this thing to try, so I'm using that as for playback only. So, I hope you enjoyed this amazing demonstration and updated my Sony TC-580 reel-to-reel tape recorder. And that'll be it for now. I hope you enjoy it. Talk again later.